is like salivating right now. I'm so excited. Oh, let's dig in. I'm so hungry. Oh my god, this is like easily like 3 meals worth of food. Okay, let's take our first bite. Oh my god, it's so good. I don't know why I haven't gotten Chipotle in so long. It's so good. To be honest with you guys, I actually woke up a little bit ago, so I'm having a coffee. But you guys know me, after my coffee, all I drink is water. So after I finish this coffee, I'm going to water. So good. I wish I could share some of this with you guys. So how is everybody? How are you all doing? What's new with life? This past week has been so crazy. Like, crazy in the best way possible. For those of you who've come to my Twitch streams, thank you. If you're not a Twitch person, I totally get it. That's why I will continue to make content here on YouTube and only on YouTube. But my streams this week have been so good. And I'm feeling a lot of love. Let's open this queso up. Oh my god, this looks so delicious. Okay. And honestly, I learned this trick from Jenna Marbles. Is eat your burrito bowl with the chips. So then you get like a Chipotle dip almost, I guess. Honestly, the last queso I got when I was at is this called a smokehouse? It was definitely barbecue because I know I got brisket. So yeah, it was either a smokehouse or barbecue place. But they had queso there and I was so excited. I'm not even kidding you guys. It was probably the spiciest thing I've ever eaten was that queso. I couldn't even eat it. I took like one bite and was like, I can't eat any more of this. I love the Chipotle chips because some of them are like super, super salty and like super limey. And then some of them are kind of plain. So it tastes like so good when you get like the one that's like covered in salt. At least for me, I love salt. Zombie. and Zero Dawn. Katana Zero. Lisa. A Little to the Left. Little Witch in the Woods. Little Nightmares 1 and 2. I played Slime Rancher 2. A Space for the Unbound. Tacony. V Rising. Unpacking. Unravel 1 and 2. And We Were Here Together. Those are like the games that, like, I guess I completed. I've also played, like, the finals just came out, so I played the finals. I've played, Overwatch, Valorant. I played a little bit of Titanfall. Oh, I forgot to say too that I played Stray, the little cat game. I loved that game. I loved Stray. I gotta say though, I wish they had like a DLC or they're coming out with a Stray 2, because I loved that game. It was super fun. But I also got, so this is so silly of me, but last year for Christmas, I bought myself a Switch, and I haven't played any Switch games besides Pokemon. Obviously, I bought Scarlet Violet, but I really haven't played a lot of it. I actually prefer to play the older Pokemon games, like I've been playing Brilliant Diamond. Like, I think I have like 100 hours in Diamond. But this year, I definitely want to play more Switch games, like Nintendo games. Like, I want to play Kirby and Mario. I literally bought a capture card and a Switch to stream them, so I have to do that. That's something that's on my things I want to do this year. Cyberpunk, because I love like the atmosphere that Cyberpunk is in. Oh my gosh, I'm forgetting about other games I played too. That reminded me, I played Hogwarts Legacy. I love Hogwarts Legacy. The only thing is I cannot stream Hogwarts Legacy because my computer isn't powerful enough to run it and stream it at the same time, which is why I haven't beaten it yet, because I can't stream. Huge like fantasy nerd. I love, you know, mythical like magic and mythical stuff. So if you guys have any suggestions of some, you know, TV series or movie series that I should watch, I would love to know. somebody, please don't crucify me, but this is coming from a place where, like, I never read the books, so I'm not, like, a, like, know-it-all when it comes to, like, how the story is precisely supposed to go, like, how it was written. I just base if I like it, you know, based off if I like it or not, not based off the books. And as somebody who's also read most of the Harry Potter books, I haven't read all of them, but somebody who's read most of the Harry Potter books, I still really like the Harry Potter movies. I think they're awesome. I think that sometimes there needs to be a separation of, like, the book and then the movie adaptation. It's like, the movie is based off of the books. It's not a exact one-to-one from the books, you know what I mean? So, that's just my opinion, but I know that, like, when it comes to the franchises such as Lord of the Rings and Harry Potter, which are so massive, you know, people can, you know, get very critical of it. It's quite